Salam everybody. Sometimes power breakdown of this kind is also quite welcoming feature, because you'll get to know my real voice than amplified voice. Anyway, we are powerless, but yet we are not voiceless. We are not voiceless anyway. The topic chosen for this morning is this: then and now the same. Then and now the same. What do I mean by then? What do we understand by now? Why do we say the same? If it is same then and now, is it a welcoming thing? Is it a positive thing? If a child continues to be a child then and now, something wrong with the child. A stunted growth. The child should grow into an adult. Don't you think so? Therefore, child remaining a child without growth, then and now, the same, is not a positive sign. After joining an educational institution, having received education in respect of knowledge and academic excellence, if I remain same then and now on the day of admission, it is all waste of money for my parents. I remember my mother wanted me to be a chartered accountant. She spoke to a senior chartered accountant in those days, long back, 50 years ago. And she spoke to a very senior chartered accountant man and paid already 10,000 rupees in those days to join as an article under that man, training to be a CA. Next morning, I told my mother, I am unfit to maintain home accounts. I am unfit to write dobi account. Impossible to become chartered accountant. You will be not only losing 10,000, you will be losing my life also. I cannot be accountant. Impossible. Please don't waste your hard-earned money, I told her. Somehow, goodness prevailed upon her. She was the education officer, and she went to the chartered accountant and said, sir, this is what my son said, what shall we do? He said, no, doesn't matter, I will train him. You may train him, but he refuses to get trained. And he is afraid of figures, what to do? Chartered accountant must deal with figures. And my son is afraid of figures, what shall we do? Then he said, thank you, Amma, and he returned the 10,000 money. I felt as if I won the lottery. So we know the area where we are unfit. And then and now I am the same in respect of accounts. After my retirement, about 14 years ago, here, after long period of service, about 17 years or so, I retired about 14 years ago. Now, of course, I am an honorary there. And there was an offer. Mr. Anil Kumar, where would you like to work? They said, after retirement. I said, I am unfit in all important areas. Unfit. Why? I cannot keep anything confidential in my life. Impossible. Everything is open. If you tell me anything, it amounts to telling BBC, that's all. So I cannot be taken into any confidential circles or any office units where topmost secrecy is necessary. I am unfit. Number two, I am much more unfit to be in account section. And I don't know where to put zero, in front or behind. Because life is a zero. And surprisingly enough, then and now the same in respect of accounts, no change in me. No improvement and no development. So do you call it any advancement or progress or anything positive? No. Same. And even as devotees, when we come here, we come with same, with some kind of commitment, dedication and all that. Then and now and the same. Why? If we put the question, how far have you gone in devotion? I do not know. How far have you gone in sadhana? I am doubtful. How many human values you cultivated? I do not know, but inhuman values have come to me. Human gone. Inhuman. Where are you? Then and now the same. Therefore, age is advancing. Years are passing. But still life has become a question. Where am I? To what extent should I travel? What is it I want to achieve? What is it I have achieved? Nothing. Then and now the same. Therefore, in one sense, then and now the same is not positive. Is something abhorring. Is something to be condemned. Is something not to be imitated. Therefore, as devotees, my friends, let us not be the same then and now. Every one of us should question ourselves to what extent we have evolved. At least I am happy to know that I have not evolved. Instead of thinking I have evolved by not evolving, it is a Himalayan ignorance. It is oceanic blunder that I don't want to commit it. So, every time, just as every education institution makes an assessment of its academic record and courses offered, our life account, self-audit or self-inquiry is also needed. My friends, my balance sheet, as I know, is a big zero. I don't think that I achieved anything. Still same. Then and now same. Why? Baba speaks of realizing divinity within. Have I realized it? I do not know. And Baba said, you see me in everyone. Am I seeing in everyone? I don't think so. And Swami said, love all, serve all. Launan sarunan, that we know. And Swami always said, help ever, hurt never. We do opposite. Help never, hurt ever. Speak softly and sweetly. We are always harsh and rude. Speak harshly, rudely, crudely. I don't know. Then and now, where are we? Pure heart is the temple of God. I don't know, it is in words, but not where the pure heart is, I do not know. Thank God there is no heart problem. So what is it? What are the things? I to we, he said. But I do not know more than I, that's all. I don't know. Simple things, Baba said. And they could not be practiced. And he said the non-dual bliss, Advaita Ananda, speaks of supreme bliss, Brahmananda. He speaks of infinite bliss, Brahmananda, Advaita Ananda. We do not know. Brahmananda is a film actor in Telugu film. I know that Brahmananda, but not Atmanandam, I do not know. Where are we? So then and now the same. But on the other hand, some artificial image has developed. All people think Anil Kumar is a good devotee, great devotee. When Anil Kumar says he is not, they think so. And I am not a fool yet to believe it, because I know that there is a long way to go. So when people say you are that and this, and when we begin to feel that I am that and this, you will have extra growth. That extra growth is cancerous, carcinogenic. Extra temperature, extra pressure, extra sugar will take you to the extra world, not this. So we developed a kind of artificial, imaginary, hypothetical, fictitious personality, mythical personality, which is not a reality. Then and now the same. Once in Vrindavan, why once every time? Swami asked me to speak in Vrindavan. If I have any remembrance, any memory of my stay in Vrindavan worth mentioning, worth recalling, worth memory, worth remembrance, is only this. Every day he used to ask me to speak in front of him. That is enough for me. If you just keep one gunny bag of currency and one occasion to speak in front of 10,000 audience, I would prefer this, not that. What to do? I don't know whether it's a weakness or a merit, I do not know. But Swami, certainly, I don't say, made use of my weakness. Somehow, that helped me to study Swami more and more and share my experience with everybody and serve people. And he used to ask me to speak every time. Once mood was disturbing. When any boy does anything, Swami gets disturbed. Something like pelting a stone in a pond. When you pelt a stone in a pond, it sends ripples. The whole pond is disturbed. Like that, if any boy or any lecturer does anything which is not expected, Swami gets disturbed. We had all jolts and lashes, slashes, bumps and jumps. Abbo, enough for many lives to come. We have seen the mountain and the deep valley also. So, he was disturbed. But somehow he wants, Swami's greatness is this. He doesn't continue to be in that mood. That is greatness. Whereas you and I continue to be in that mood and make hell out of heaven. Yes. Even mind is disturbed, we'll impose curfew at home. Nobody should talk to anybody, nobody should cut any joke, nobody should watch TV, nobody should sing, because my mood is not all right. Swami is not like that. He'll get out of that mood within seconds. Within seconds. And it will continue both the moods at the same time. Abbo, he alone can do it. He can smile, Allah, Allah, how are you? Useless fellow, idiot, you are a pig and lamb. Same time, ayyayo, pakka dramatist. We cannot see. One several man, unfortunately, made one person sit in the veranda. Somehow he is completely out of form. Somehow Swami, I don't say out of form, kept him at a distance. I will only put it, so-and-so is under treatment. So that man was under treatment. How do we know? We don't have list of the people under treatment, you know. This several man unfortunately made him sit in the front. Swami gave him out of the room. Called that several man. You are a pig, donkey, idiot, fox. Hello, how are you? When did you come here? Hello, how are you? He said, I will kick you out of the restaurant and be careful. Hello, how is wife? Huh? How are children doing well? Come on. Are what? Impossible for us. Come on, try. Any one of you try. Both the sides of people will beat you. Nobody will trust you for a lifetime. But it's possible for Swami to be like that. That morning he was out of moods. Somehow he wanted to be back. Anil Kumar, come on, you say for few. Speak for some time. Thoda baat karo. Okay. And then I said, I could understand he wants to be quite jovial and humorous. And I said, Swami, excuse me for what I am going to say. First we should get divine insurance coverage. Or else you have to collect your luggage from the bus station or railway station. So I wanted to have insurance coverage in the beginning. Swami, excuse me for what I am going to say. I have nothing wrong to say what is there. So safe and secure. Then I said, Swami, there is a fight, there is a competition between man and God. Swami started looking at me. And in this match, man won, God lost. Then he was telling boys. He has become, that's what Swami says. Some madder. I was prepared for this. Then I said, why? Why incarnation, avatar, comes down on earth and moves amongst us? Why? Dharma samsthapanardhaya, to establish dharma. Paritranaya sadhuna, to protect pious people. Vinashaya chatuskrutam, to destroy the wicked people. Sambhavami yuge yuge, from time to time I incarnate. Alright? God comes down as avatar to destroy the wicked and to save the pious. Very good. Why did you take avatar so many times? Why? First time you failed, therefore second avatar. Second avatar failed, therefore third avatar. We have dashavataras, 10 chances. All the 10 times you have failed. You are not reformed, no. Even as Shirdi Baba you failed. Now you are here as a Sai Baba. Therefore God failed. God is the loser in this competition. Then he wanted to see what I would say next. Then he immediately said, man won. Why? You may be born again and again as avatar 10 times, but I will not change. Then and now the same. We'll continue to be same. Nothing, no improvement will be like that. Come again and again is fine. On the other hand, we are giving you a chance to come again by remaining then and now the same. Or else you would not have come at all. Then Swami laughed and laughed. Correct. Mallikeppu. He wanted me to repeat again. Then and now the same. We refuse to improve, we refuse to grow. So in respect of humanity, then and now the same. But in respect of divinity, also then and now the same. In respect of God also. Why? Does it not look funny? No. God remaining then and now the same is positive. Man remaining now and then same is a curse. God remaining then and now the same is divinity. Man remaining now and then the same is inhumanity, is a failure. Bhagwan Baba, at one time, at the lunch table, it was lunch time, and curd was served to everybody, curd, what Western people call it yogurt, but pakka South Indian curd. This yogurt is no comparison in front of it. பக்கா சவுத் இண்டியன் வில்லேஜ் மேட், வில்லேஜ் மேட், நாட் டவுன்ஸ். டவுன்ஸ் ஆர் ஆர்டிஃபிஷியல் மில்க் பேக்கெட்ஸ். சீச்சி, பக்கா டவுன் வில்லேஜ். அண்ட் இன் அர்தன் பாட்ஸ், நாட் ஸ்டெயின்லெஸ் ஸ்டீல், அர்தன் பாட்ஸ் தே மேக் கர்ட் வில்லேஜஸ். யூ நீட் எ க்ரோபார் டு பிரேக் இட், வெரி டேஸ்டி. வித் தி மில்க் ஃபியூ இன்ச்சஸ், ஐ மீன் கிரீம் ஃபியூ இன்ச்சஸ் திக். தி மாடர்ன் யங்ஸ்டர்ஸ் கேனாட் ட்ரீம் ஆஃப் சச் எ கர்ட். வா, வெரி நைஸ். இட் இஸ் சோ டெம்டிங் அண்ட் தட் இஸ் கெப்ட் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் அஸ். சுவாமி ஜெட் கம் அண்ட் ஸ்டார்ட் ஈட்டிங். ஐ ஃபெல்ட் லிட்டில் கில்ட்டி. வென் த ஹோஸ்ட் டஸ் நாட் ஈட், கெஸ்ட் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஈட்டிங், இட் இஸ் இன்டீசென்ட், இல் மேனர்ட் அண்ட் அன்கல்ச்சர்ட். So I said, Swami, I feel guilty. If you just start eating, we'll do the rest of the things. You take one spoon, so that I'll complete the whole thing. That's what I mean. You know, Baba, what he said? Curd and milk, the cream, I ate a lot in the previous incarnation. I'm disgusted, vexed with this. Therefore, I don't touch it now. Then and now the same Krishna then. Now, Bhagavan says, Sai Baba, then and now the same. I was talking to my friends yesterday along the same lines which I am sharing with the English speaking people, because you love to hear them. And it is also another time Swami started identifying people in the veranda. Suddenly he looked at a person. Where do you come from? That man said, I am from East Godavari. Oh, I see. Then he went on mentioning 100 names of devotees from East Godavari, which he visited 30 years ago. We don't remember what we have had for breakfast just an hour ago. Here is our God who makes mention of the people whom he visited 30 years ago. East Godavari. How is he? Then he said, why do you look like that? Swami, Avizit, you are telling all their names. Then Swami said, I am not new. Same. I know everybody is same. I am not new. That's what Baba said. In Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, O Arjuna, you are not new, I am not new. We were there, we are here, we will continue to be there. Then and now the same. Bhagavan Baba suggesting, nobody is new to me, I know everybody. To one great musician from Andhra, of course he sang film songs in Tamil, Malayalam, Telugu, Ghantasala, a very famous singer. Swami told him, Ghantasala, I know you for 7 generations, for 7 lives, I'm sorry. I know you for 7 lives. Ghantasala then was older to Baba in respect of age, quite younger to him. But he says, I know you for 7 lives. Ghantasala, the wise man, kept quiet because he knew that Baba, then and now the same, the eternal witness, the divine who followed him all these 7 lives. So he knows the past, present and future, then and now the same, the eternal witness, the eternal, immortal, blemishless, permanent divinity, the one of continuity to eternity, the one without the second, is Bhagavan Sri Sat Sai Baba, then and now the same. No change at all, no change at all. Once Bhagavan was talking to somebody, he has got that element of Krishna in him. He told in Telugu to me, say no to whatever I say, say no first. Okay, Swami. Ready. Then he went to V.K. Narasimha, the then editor of Sanatana Sarathi. Then Swami told him, Narasimha, would you come with me? He said, Swami, I will come with you. Anil Kumar, what do you say? No. See, Narasimha, I want to take you, you want to come, this man is saying no. Then Swami said, Narasimha, why Anil Kumar is saying no? I do not know, Swami. I am elder to him by 40 years. No competition at all. See, he is saying no, I want to take you. And then he said in Telugu, say louder no. No, Swami. Why he shouts, I don't know. That is it. Once, Rama Brahmam, the caretaker of Vrindavan, very great man, I tell you. We are all nothing in front of him. In respect of devotion, we are nothing. That man withstood so many shocks from Swami. We are only just reading others' experiences, spending time. We are just on visitor's visa. But Rama Brahmam is a great man, very great man. What happened to Ram Brahma? He told me once, Swami was about to come for darshan. Called Rama, Ram Brahma, come here. Go there in Vrindavan. Go there where all devotees are seated. Go and tell them there is no darshan today. Rama Brahma has got well-built personality. North Indian complexion. He looks like moneyed man. Ah, well built. So he went there. He went to that Sai Ram, said everybody, there is no darshan today, Sai Ram. There is no darshan today, Sai Ram. He circumambulated the whole Sai Ram, said there. Sai Ram, no darshan. Swami started coming from here. Swami started coming. This man, no darshan, Swami giving darshan behind. No darshan in the front, darshan behind. No darshan. Swami says, he makes fun of people. An element of Krishna's mischief, then and now the same. Same. And he was very much annoyed with one trust member. These are all secrets which I am telling you. As I told you, my weakness, nothing I can keep, nothing impossible. I am ready for anything. What is there? And he is disturbed or upset with one senior man, very senior man, with whom he had breakfast, lunch, snack, dinner. Oh yes, he was never at the dining table with that man. Somehow, he is under treatment. And he goes straight into Swami's room every time. He has got the divine license. So, because Swami is upset, what he did was, Ram Ramam, come here. That man will come. Tell him, don't come. Ask him to go. Very important man. What to do? So that man came there, breakfast time, taka taka. Swami said, ask him to go. But he did not ask him to tell him not to go, not to get in. How to convey this? Can you ask him to go? But Swami didn't say that. Don't allow him to get in. But he did not say, tell him to get out. He did not say. So what is Ram Brahma, what to do? He was coming.
Sai Ram, sir.
Sai Ram. Sai Ram. Sai Ram. That man understood. He left. This divine romance continued for 3 days. 4 times every time. 3 times at least. Breakfast time, lunch time, snack time, dinner time. That man comes. Ram Ram says, Sai Ram. And on the 4th day, Swami comes there and sees this impairment. Are what happened to you all these 4 days? Where have you been? See, that Ram Brahma might not have allowed you. Useless fellow. See, he did not tell me. Are you are here? Ayo, ayo. Papa. Come, come, come. Ram Brahma was watching this. Helpless. After lunch, he left. Then he said, Swami, this is my fate, what shall I do? Swami said, be happy, I used you as an instrument in my mission. Don't worry whether people praised you or condemned you, no, don't bother about it. I used you as an instrument in my divine mission as a sort of expression of resentment at this moment. Be happy. That element is always there, Swami. He does like that. In sports time, January, he told me when I was the principal there in Bangalore, Anil Kumar, never tell what the items that your students are doing for the sports meet. Never tell him. Be careful. Then he goes to Brunga, Puttaparthi boys, that Anil Kumar is here. He is not telling me what items they should be. See that. So you also don't tell anybody. Then he goes to Anantapur girls. Those boys, I don't know what they are doing. I am here, every day they see me. They don't ask me to say their, see their rehearsals. What they are doing, I do not know. We shall also be ready. Then girls also, they are ready. Then he comes to boys. Anantapur girls are ready with sports. They are ready to jump from Hanuman statue. If they are in higher level, very good. They are ready to jump. Are you fellows playing with marbles? Girls, competition like that. He has got that element. But it is very nice to enjoy that. But man through the process will pass through grinding. It is nice to hear that. Nice to repeat it. But it is a testing time to pass through that period. For the man involved in the game. Those who watch the cricket match, it is fine. But the losers, the fighters, they know how serious, what tension it is. This kind of an element is always there. Once Pandavas are feeling very sad for their bad situation. And Ashwatthama and others have decided to kill them. All the Pandavas will finish off. So what to do? Pandavas have no other thing other than to cry for help in front of Bhagavan. This is a lesson for all of us. If we are to cry, let us cry in front of Bhagavan, not in front of man. If we cry in front of Bhagavan, he will help you. If you cry in front of fellow man, he will exploit you. You become cheap in front of him. Let us cry in front of him. So Pandavas cried. Then Krishna had a beautiful plan. Very good plan. He made a very big pit He wanted Pandavas to dig very big pit, made all of them sit there, had a wooden plank above that. Wooden plank above that. And then they are quite safe. And then Krishna saw Durvasa coming over there. Durvasa, you sit on the plank. Okay, Swami. And protect Pandavas. Okay. And then, at that moment, people were in search of Pandavas. Where are they? Where are they? And then, when they asked, where are Pandavas? They are here, he said it. They are here, out of disgust. He was sitting on the wooden plank. They are here. Then they thought, this man is known for anger. How can we question again? Thank you, sir, they left. That's how Pandavas are saved. Krishna had such a knack of saving people. Of saving, wonderful knack. Yes. Because when fighting was going on between Bhima and Duryodhana, fight was going on. And Duryodhana is not a small fellow. He has got a PhD in fighting, wrestling, yeah. Well, Bhima, the elite in fighting, yes, not ordinary fellows. Fata fata they are fighting. Then Krishna gave a signal from a distance. Hit him near the thighs. Finish. So Bhima took the chance and hit him right on the thighs. And Duryodhana was finished. He did it like that. Krishna managed it like that. And Swami is a technique of efficient managing. Nice management, bringing about a kind of element of mischief. Then and now the same. Then and now the same. Swami, what a lecture you have given to Arjuna. Bhagavad Gita, Abba, what a lecture it is. Swami said, Krishna gave lecture to one Arjuna then. Today you are all Arjunas. I am giving talks every day. The whole Kulwanta hall is full of Arjunas who are listening to my discourses. Yes. Then and now the same. The difference is in quantity. Of course, quality, individually we know. Quality, individually we know. Because we are then and now the same. Therefore, and somebody asked, Swami, you lifted one mountain, Govardhan Paratam, then. Are why? I lift all these mountains around, not one. Yes, I can lift all. Then and now the same power of might, the same power. And it was Krishna who said, Sambhavami yuge yuge, I'll be born again and again. Makara pidita mate bhamununadu vikshinchi rakshinsuna prema phalamu. Vikshinchi rakshinsuna prema phalamu. When Gajendra, that elephant, was drawn into the pond by the crocodile, it was I who rescued Gajendra. Then and now the same Krishna. Akhladamoppa prakladu palimpa. Akhladamoppa prakladu palimpa. Aparama purushudu. The one who gave safety to Prahlada. Who rescued Prahlada then. Yes. వైదర్భిగాచినట్టి అవ్యాజ కరుణ వైదర్భి వదినను గచినట్టి అవ్యాజ కరుణ. ద ద్రౌపది హు వాజ్ సేవ్డ్ దెన్. దెన్ స్వామి కంక్లూడ్స్ దట్ పోయమ్. పలుమారు పుట్టున చలువ ఎల్ల, పలుమారు పుట్టున చలువ ఎల్ల, తెలుసు కొమ్ము కస్తూరి నా తెనె మనసు. ఏ లెటర్ రిటర్న్ టు కస్తూరి, స్వామి రోట్ దిస్. ద వన్ హూ సేవ్డ్ ప్రహ్లాద, ద వన్ హూ సేవ్డ్ ద్రౌపది, ద వన్ హూ సేవ్డ్ మెనీ పీపుల్ ఇన్ ద పాస్ట్ ఈజ్ ద వెరీ సేమ్ హూ టేక్స్ లైఫ్ ఆఫ్టర్ లైఫ్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్కార్నేషన్ అవతార్ భగవాన్ శ్రీ సత్సాయి బాబా. దట్స్ వాట్ హీ మేడ్ ద స్టేట్మెంట్ దెన్ అండ్ నౌ ద సేమ్. Then and now the same. The kind of things he said, the kind of leelas that he performed. Yes. You know, Durvasa is known for his anger. Of course, that anger positive. Our anger is revengeful, most dangerous. But Rishi's anger is something for the welfare of the humanity. Durvasa said to Pandavas one day, I will be coming for lunch this afternoon with 500 shishyas. Where are the Pandavas? They are passing through a period of exile. They are in a forest then. Nothing. And this man comes with 500 people for lunch. What to do? So Draupadi had no other alternative. He prayed, Durvasa, you have your bath and come back. So they went to the river to have their bath. Draupadi dialed number 9. Dialed number 9. Yes, phone number 9. Krishna said, I am coming. Our phones fail, but not Swami's. Swami's tone never fails. He appeared there. What, Draupadi, what do you want? Swami, Durvasa wants to come with 500 disciples for lunch. We don't have enough to eat. What to do? If I say no, he may curse. Then Krishna made a drama there. Draupadi, I am helpless now. Swami, you are helpless? If you are helpless, who will help us now? Don't say that. You only should help us. Then Krishna says, Draupadi, no doubt I come to the rescue of my devotees. Bhakta palana. Yes. I take care of my devotees. But I am Rishi Manasa Sanchari. I move in the hearts of my devotees, of Rishis. Durvasa is a Rishi. So I am there in his heart. I am here to protect you. What can I do? I may fix now. A very big dilemma. To be or not to be, that is the question. What shall I do? Draupadi, Swami, no drama like that. You are the only man who should save me from the situation. And Krishna says, is there any food, lunch, any food left there? Leftover food? Swami, I cleaned all the vessels also. Nothing is there. No, you search again. She could find a rice grain. And he gave that rice grain to Krishna. Krishna has put it on his tongue. Ah, my lunch is over. There Durvasa with 500 disciples had their bath about to return. They found their bellies already full. Neck full. They could not walk. They were rolling on the sand out of exhaustion. Ate so much. Then Durvasa sent a message, our lunch is over, we are not coming. Then and now the same had happened in Kodaikanal. It was the first year of my service in Vrindavan. First year of service is a honeymoon period. Even if we commit some mistakes, God will tolerate and excuse, give you some margin. Next year, honeymoon period will be over. Then life is a challenge every day, every moment. Honeymoon period is known to all married people. Even a wife prepares in a horrible way, to a husband it's amrut. Yes, honeymoon period. She may forget salt. That will be very nice. Because this is important. She may forget to add pepper. Abba, very nice. And the husband may be very ugly. And to the wife, Abba, you are most handsome man on earth. Honeymoon period. So that was my honeymoon period, first year of service with Bhagavan. And Narayana Seva, feeding the poor, not poor feeding. Poor feeding is of lower standard. Feeding the poor is of higher standard. So, feeding the poor was arranged for 500 people. But on coming to know that Bhagavan is serving food, thousands started coming. Food stuff is over in the kitchen. That lady called me, Anil Kumar, elderly lady. Please tell Swami, exhausted. Food is over. Because that is the first period, I don't know how dangerous it is to speak like that. How risky it is. How suicidal it is. I don't know. So I went there. I said, Swami, I am. Food is over, Swami. What? Swami, food is... Get up! Don't say like that. I don't want anybody to say no. I don't want anybody to say over. What? Sir, go back. I ran like them. Something like a cricket ball, pata hit, it goes to a distance. Or football kick to a distance. I left that spot. Ran also. Went to those people and said, you have sent me and I paid for it. They said, what to do, Anil Kumar? Then they went back to the kitchen to cook again, if there is anything there. But to their surprise, please believe me, to their surprise, all the vessels are full of sambar and rice. Everything full. Then I came to Swami again. Yemi. Swami, all full there. But you said nil. Anil said nil, but it is full. That is Swami, you know that he said it. That is Swami, you know that. Really wonderful. That's what Krishna did then. That Swami is doing now. Then and now the same. Then and now the same. I'll also give you another experience. Brahma wanted to play and test Krishna. There's competition among gods also. Nothing wrong when we compete as humans. Of course, in a much worse way. So Brahma wanted to test Krishna. What did he do? He made all cows, and the cowherd boys disappear. Finish. None of them are seen there. It was the evening time. And the family people are waiting for the boys to return. None of them return. They are waiting for the cows to return. No cow returned. No calf. So all villagers came there crying, Krishna, Krishna, what happened? And Krishna smiles. They are all here, come on, you see. All cowherd boys are there, cows, all are full.
they are all here.
Meaning, Krishna himself has taken the form of many cowherd boys. Krishna himself has taken the form of so many cows. Krishna himself has taken the form of so many cows there. So nobody was found missing. He has taken all forms, one into many. One into many. Same thing had happened 30 years ago at a place by name Palasa in Srikakulam district of Andhra Pradesh. There they constructed a nice temple for Baba. It was the inauguration day. They fixed some priests, some Nadaswaram fellows, and some other people also. But on that day, nobody came to Swami's temple. Nobody. Why? Kanchi Kamakoti Pitadipati Shankara Swami was on visit to that place. All fellows went there. Ayyappa Swami temple was to be inaugurated. All priests went there. Nobody there for Swami's temple. One gentleman by name Narasimhan of railways, he was the man in charge of the temple. He was feeling so bad that nobody were there around. 10 minutes before the auspicious moment, 5 priests came, 5 Nadaswaram fellows came, few more devotees attended. Function was simply grand. At the end, this Narasimhan wanted to pay money to that orchestra people, Nadaswaram, to priest. He opened his zip bag and about to pay money. None of the fellows are there. Where are they? Nobody. And after 6 months when he came to Swami's darshan, Swami tells him, how was the inauguration of the temple? Where are the priests from? Where is that Nagaswaran gang? Where is the money? Swami, yes, I only became into many. I only came in that form. Swami has taken many forms of orchestra group, has taken all the forms of priests and made that inauguration a grand success. Then and now the same. Like this, my friends, there are many, many anecdotes, there are many, many episodes which are repeated in the present avatar, Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Why? He manifested a ring, a very beautiful ring. And he said, it is presented to Krishna by his father-in-law. In Kodaikanal, it is a chance for divine romance. We can be very close to him and ask any question. When once you are out, your life is in question. There, you can ask any question. Swami, father-in-law gave the ring? Which father-in-law? Because he has got 8 wives. 8. So which father-in-law gave him? Then Baba said, when he married Bhadri, Bhadri's father gave this ring. Bhadri. It is something, a bull with horns on the ring. I saw that. And Swami said, the father of this Bhadri arranged an open competition. Anyone who will fight with the bull and wins the race here, I'll offer my daughter in marriage to him. So many people came there, fought with the bull, successfully failed. Many of them died also. Finally, Krishna came. Just with one stroke, he killed that. And then the father offered this girl Bhadri in marriage to Krishna. It is at that moment he gave this ring, Swami Maitreya Chandra. I have seen that. Why I? All those people present on that day, they all saw that. Then it's an opportunity for me. Swami, one question. Now what? Krishna had 8 wives, not nice to hear. As humans, we are not able to manage with one. God has 8 problems he must be having. Then Baba said, chi. You are speaking of cinema Krishna. You go to movies and you speak of movies Krishna. Cha-cha-cha. No. He didn't have 8 wives. They are not women. Oh, I am thinking wife is a woman. But Swami said they are not women. Then who are else? Who are they? Then Baba said they are not women. Your heart is a lotus flower. This lotus flower, the human heart, has 8 petals. When you offer your heart, keep it at the lotus feet of God. That 8 petaled lotus is an offering to God. Astadala. 8 astadala petal. Astadala pushpa, the lotus, hridaya pushpa, the lotus of the heart. Yeah, 8 wives. You too have 8 wives. Heart. Oh. Very good justification. Then I said, Swami, 8 wives account you have given, good. But about his affair with 16,000 gopikas. 16,000 gopikas Krishna had. Not 1 or 2. How about that account? There are 6 chakras in the human body. Shat chakra. The one chakra here is Sahasrara. Sahasrara. Sahasra meaning 1,000. Here there is a lotus with Sahasra, 1,000 petals. Each has got 16 shades. 16 into 1,000, 16,000, Sahasrara. In Kundalini Yoga, in the deep meditation, the Kundalini from the bottom, Mooladhara, will be in the ascent in the upward direction, comes to Sahasrara, 1,000 petals. That is Samadhi. So, 16,000 petal is the state of Samadhi. When Kundalini in the ascent across the Sahasrara, the Satchakra reaches the Sahasrara, that what it is, not 16,000 women in speech. Oh, that is a divine accountancy. The divine accountant. Punyastri Pariveshtito Sri Satcha Sai Vibho. Gopastri Pariveshtito. As Krishna is surrounded by Gopastri, all cowherd girls, Gopikas. And today Swami, Punyastri Pariveshtito, all the women of merit. Woman is not an individual by gender alone. A woman is symbolic. A woman represents sensitivity, receptivity, devotion, surrender, sacrifice, love and truth. All the devotees are women. Punyastri Pariveshtito Sri Satcha Sai Vibho. He is only the man. He is only the man. All are women. Then and now the same. Same drama is repeated again and again. Swami, his actions, his movements are mostly of Lord Krishna's type. His discourses, his management, his leadership. He does it and gives credit to boys and to devotees. He calls Arjuna, "Oh Vijaya." Vijaya means the triumphant. Vijaya means the winner. Vijaya means victorious. Vijaya. But Arjuna knows how much of Vijaya he is. Because after Krishna left this world, Arjuna was beaten by street boys. Street boys. So what is his might? All the might is because of Krishna alone. Similarly, Bhagavan Baba was the strength and might to all of us. And today, we find people suddenly aging. Suddenly aging. The man of smiles, the man of health, the man of activity, the man of bossism, the man of ego and pride today got lost. Where is he? Krishna's strength is not there. Krishna's support is not there. Today we should get his support from within. We should get the energy from within. So, just as Krishna has given credit to Arjuna, Swami gives credit to his devotees. On the dais he said many times, "None can ever equal my devotees. My devotees are number one in this world." That's what Baba said. Are we really number one? No. That number one is only one, Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba. Because we are by the side of that one, we are number one in this world. He does it and gives us the credit. That is Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna was never a king. He was never an emperor. He never enjoyed any position. He gave positions to Pandavas. He made others kings. And he was never the king for himself. Bhagavan Baba gave us positions while he has no position for himself. That is the lesson of Baba and Krishna. Let others have positions. Let me not be an imposition to others. Let them be in position. I am not in position. Baba is a king maker, but not a king himself. Krishna is a king maker and not a king for himself. That is the lesson of avatar. He always serves and he never allowed others to serve him. Krishna washed the horses. Krishna healed the wounds of the horses in the battlefield. He was only a charioteer, a driver. But the owner of the chariot is Arjuna himself. Wow. I had an occasion to visit Kurukshetra, Haryana. I went to that, my friends. I went to that place, Kurukshetra. Our good friends are so kind enough to have taken me there. There I have seen, 40 feet height, I tell you, a chariot, and Arjuna on the chariot, and Krishna is charioteer. All the horses and the wheels, on a high pedestal, Kurukshetra. And Arjuna's face, how beautifully they carved Arjuna's face, full of fury, anger, heart. The very face will tell you. And Krishna turning back, a smiling face, Chidarupam. Madhuradipate akhilam madhuram. Appa, appa, what a face it is. The horses ready to jump, and the flag there, and they keep Bhagavad Gita, loudspeakers, recitation all the 24 hours. Kurukshetra, when I stood very close to that, I felt very proud of my country as a Bharatiya, the land of Kurukshetra, the land of Krishna, the land of Avatar, Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. I felt very proud of it. I could not leave that statue. I was watching Arjuna and Krishna at the same time. My friends said, it is time that we should go back to Chandigarh, that we should go back to Sahabad, where there is state level youth conference. Anil Kumar, please come. Aray, Arjuna is here, Krishna is here, how can I come? And the water all around, water, water all around. There open you find Arjuna and Krishna, 40 feet height. What is all that water, all that river? People told me, here Kurukshetra battle took place. 1 lakh soldiers died. That is all the blood which is washed by the waters of this river. That's what you find there. Abba. One should be fortunate enough to have seen such a sight. They also said, there is a well there at a distance, out of which Draupadi has drawn water out of that well, had her daily bath, which you can see even today. Exhibition on Krishna's life and mission is there in Kurukshetra, Haryana, of international standard, which I didn't have time to see. Maybe Baba is going to give me another chance to go there, who knows. If we complete the whole thing, where is the chance to go again? So I feel it is only a comma, but not a full stop. There may be another chance to go. Same Krishna, that kind of. Bhagavad Gita is the text that calls for action. It's not for laziness, no. Don't sleep. Spend time in slumber. Come on, get up. Kuru Nandana, Kuru, do it, Nandana, my child. Krishna calls Arjuna, Kuru Nandana, Kuru, do it, Nandana, my child. Come on, fight, yeah. Bhagavan Baba says, laziness is rust and dust. Realization is rest and best. Same, then and now, the same. Work, worship, wisdom, says Bhagavan, come on, do it. Work. Same call. And it is Krishna who said, Ananyas chintayanto mam yejanah paryupasate tesham chabhyuktana yoga kshemam vahamyaham. If you think of me, if you surrender to me, it is my responsibility to take care of you, said Krishna in Kurukshetra battle. Why fear? Why fear when I am here? Says Bhagavan Satya Sai Krishna today. Why fear when I am here? Yes. It was Krishna who said in my Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Dharman Parichajya Mamekam Saranam Braja. Come on, give up everything, surrender to me, I shall do it. Bhagavan says, come to my lotus feet, place all your burdens at my feet, return with bliss and ananda, the same clarion call, Gita call of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba today. My friends, things start coming to my memory more and more, but I should not exhaust you. I should not make you get tired. I know that 3 canteens, South Indian, North Indian, Western canteen, are welcoming you there. I don't want you to fast this afternoon with a lot of pressure against my wish. I am forced to stop now. Because I want you to come again next week also. My friends, you may get audience anywhere, everywhere. But you don't get this kind of audience. Only such a Sai devotees are the best audience, best listeners all over the world. Because they listen to you with all receptivity, with all the prayer, with all the devotion. It is my good luck to have you every Sunday, every morning here. I pray Bhagavan to bless all of us. Jai Sai Ram. Om Samasta Lokaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Samasta Lokaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Samasta Lokaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satchai Baba Ji Ki. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satchai Baba Ji Ki. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satchai Baba Ji Ki. The coming two Sundays I'll be out of station. I'll be visiting UK and I'll be spending 10 days there in Great Britain or United Kingdom or England, whatever you call, visiting Sai centers from 16th to 26th. I'll be back on 27th. I beg to be excused for my absence for the coming two Sundays. Thank you very much. Sai Ram. Thank you.